you can see how many data we have. We got 1,270 data. They can recall your IP address. They can check you how long did you spend for answer the question in second. Did you need finish it or not? All this come from the system, okay? Don't do it by hand. Okay. Time one, time two, time three. One, two, three. So this person is assigned to 2 hours. This person, 2 hours. And how about public or private? He is assigned, this person is assigned in public. And this is one of the sample. Okay, the independent variable. Let me ask you. How did you get this number? Actually, this number should be how did you get this number? 3, 2, 3, 2, 2, because this is 1, 2, 3. So this is 3. This is 2, this is 2. How did you do it?
Change variables.
How to do it? This column is created later. Okay. When you collect data from the system, let's know this column. Let's know this column.
Yang file apa sih yang data? Yang transform.
Masa transform sih. Macam ni.
My question is, how did you get this number? How are you going to do the Antuya Nova? Independent variable? This one. And the dependent variable is this one. This one is come from the, we got the average for the thinking. This three is about the dependent variable. Okay, so we got the average of them. Okay, I'm going to conduct a two-way ANOVA. This no data. I will delete this. This is empty. Delete. How did you get this one? Timing? Actually, this timing, 1, 2, 3 is this, 1, 2, 3. Okay. The mode, the form, public and private. Two-way ANOVA, 2 by 3, 6 different combination. Papi, how did you get this number? When you got a system from system, it's omitted, just 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0.
Transform, transform
how
to...
How did you do it? In SPSS?
Yes.
Go to copy this file to Excel. Okay? Don't use menu, okay? Otherwise you will do for the whole night, okay? Don't do stupid things. So you got, this is 2. So you got 2. This is 3. You got 3. Okay, so this is the independent variable. And this one. Public is 1, private is 2. It's 2, so this is 2. 2. This is 1. Okay, I'm going to do the 2-way ANOVA, okay? Nobody do this in the class. Okay, that's why I say you learn a lot. The dependent variable is this one. The independent variable, timing, and this one. I'm not going to change anything. I won't see ANOVA table, two-way ANOVA table here. Actually, the two-way indexation is not sticking. It's not. It's not. It's not good. The result is not good. Is there, all of them are not significant. You see the p-value?
Yang kita pakai yang 3 ke bawah.
Oh, yang di atas enggak.
We call this an immediate. This is a short. Short response. This is a long response. So this is 3 by 2. So total there are 6 conditions. But the result is not so good. And I remember they used involvement. I'm not sure which one is involved. This is hedonic. This is involvement, okay. 23, okay, I got it. Involvement. History. Now, ANCOVA, okay. Covariant. So I've gotten the average of this one. Compute. The mean involvement equal the all, the function is below the mean. This one. So I got the average for involvement. So I know I have a covariate go here. Yes. Cover it. Like frog. Cover it. Okay. Do it again. Still. This one is significant, but this is covered. Okay. But these two are still, especially this one, is not significant. And if you actually, if it's not significant, there is no way you can do it. But still, they got different results. So you can plot timing. Boom. And you can get this one. Because the output, actually it looks like they have an interaction. Okay, and this is all paper. Maybe he used the other data set to get the result. Okay, the hypothesis A, we say when the public apology is given for this case, we say the effect of response time on dependent variable is the same as the, is not different from the immediate. That means you say these two are equal. Yes, there is no significant difference. And this one is larger than this one. But it's higher than this is long response time. The hypothesis B, the private apologies we offer, the grace period is not observed. The effect of response time in the short response is lower than. So this is greater than these two. So there's moderate. Actually, they should have an interaction. And we call this is 3 by 2. 3 by 2 between subject experiment. Okay, we have 3 different response time. Immediate, short, long. We have a different, 2 different apologies more, public and private. And this is the result. Here, the result is different what I got. The short and long, this is 3.59, and this is 3.29, that's significant. You can see the p-value is significant. And there's no difference between short and immediate. Yeah. How about for this one, the private? When the apology is given in private, okay, the short and the, they are significant. this one. And the short and the long, they have long skin. So the part will look like part. And so like this way, okay? This is the dependent variable, perceived from remorse. It is 3 and 4. And this is the immediate, short, long. For public, 3.4, here, this is one, here, this is here, it will look like this one. For private, here, 3.53, and this two. Probably look like this one. Actually, yeah, in our case, the result is significant. 2 well known one. And the old prop. Look like this. Okay. 2 well known one. But I don't know how come I got the. My result is not significant. It's not significant. And I leave the covariant here. Covariant. These two are normal. You can see. Actually, they are significant. That's mean, okay. If you are the manager of this company, the bank, what does this mean to you? What does this mean to you? Whenever your customer complains about your service because your APP is not working very well, what should they do? Apologize in public. If you apologize in public, the customer will perceive you feel sorry for them. There's no significant difference between this. However, if you apologize too late, more than 2 hours, the customer will feel mad to you because they don't feel you feel sorry for them. Perceived company firms quite low. So when you apologize in public, in the internet, there is no difference between 1 hour or 10 minutes. It's okay. But if you apologize to your customer in private, send email to her or to him, then you are in trouble. Okay. You must reply immediately, less than 10 minutes. Otherwise, but you see, it's different. This is an interesting story. What did you learn from this two-way-on-over? Very realistic. You never learn in the class because everything in the textbook is easy, but here is real research. The way you got the result should be very interesting, and you can report and you can publish. I think most of you are under a master's student. Yeah, so some of I remember there are 4 master students, work, and then only 2 of them come from Indonesia. They work very hard, but they didn't show up in the last couple of months. But the other 2 girls from Mongolia never show up. Is that possible for you to finish your thesis without meeting with your professor? Don't do it, okay? I don't care. You never come to ask me. Then you just waste your time. You stay in Taiwan for 2 or 3 years, you never graduate because you never know how to do your research. As a graduate student, the best way you can do, meet with your professor every week. Okay, if you don't come to see me, I don't care. Because you never get your degree. And you never learn. You will be the professor in the future. Will you call your student come to see me every week? Will you call them? No, we won't. It's up to you. If you want, finish your thesis as soon as possible and work for very good research. You can't work very hard and meet with your professor every week. Otherwise, you just waste your life. Don't waste your time. Okay, in any other country. Meeting, regular meeting. One guy from Malawi, is you or did you find anything? But you never come to see me every week. Report to me every week. That's the way you do research. Otherwise, how can you finish your research? You need everything is interact with your professor. The more you interact with your professor, the quicker you finish your degree. And the better your thesis. You don't want people thinking your thesis is trash. Throw it away. You throw it to the trash. It's worthless. As a professor, I will ask my master's student to work very good research. Otherwise, don't waste my time, okay? Every week you come to my office, I need to spend 1 hour to talk with you. What did you read? What did you got? And if you come out, nothing. Come on. You know how many hours I need to spend with you? Every week, at least 1 hour? I think that it should be more than 1 hour. Okay, you need to work very hard. And this is a two-way envelope. And this is the output I got is not significant, but I don't know how come my student got it. Okay. And I will show you the proc. The proc is here. This is proc. I didn't finish this one. The proc. How did you analyze? I remember last time I showed you. You use SEN 6 air check controller. Not 18. And each one of them, they need to run in different time period. I forgot to tell you. When you do this kind of experiment, the first one, this 7, 6 air check controller, when they run the experiment, go to system A or B or C, it's random. And after the first one, wait another 2 weeks. Let them forget this experiment. So the second one, 2 weeks later, okay? Don't repeat to the experiment. You need a time length between each experiment. So each one of them will run 3 times, random, okay? A, B, C is random, okay? I just say the number 6, the first time you pick C, maybe the number 5, keep system A, so each one will have their experiment, and they are random. The second one, for this one, when he already finishes the system C, so he maybe pick up A or B, and it's random. So each one of them, they need to go through 3 systems, okay? So I spent half hour to explain my students research to you. The most difficult part is conduct experiment, not the data analysis. But data analysis is easy. Data analysis is easy, just 1 minute you get everything. Okay? Okay, now if you got a data, in this case you have 18 data for 3 systems and 6 air traffic controllers. Are going to do the data analysis. So remember, this variable is stress. So put them in one column, okay? And I will leave. Will change. Okay, this is controller. This is nominal. This is stress. And this is system. This is the air check. You can remind yourself of this variable and this system. A is system A, 1 is system A, two is system B, three is system C. And you don't need this one. Clear. And integer. So this is system A, so this is one. This is two. This is three. That's it. And the controller you need copy the same controller. Okay, so we have one dependent variable, one independent variable. This is block. You treat them like a two-way ANOVA. I forgot to tell you one thing, very important. Okay. Remember, for each, you need at least one, more than one, more than one. For example, the ANOVA, one-way ANOVA, if you have only one data in each level, what are you going to do? Very good it is. Just one observation. This will be zero. This will be zero. So sum square will be zero. So what will happen? If sum square is zero, there's no way you can. If this is zero, then you are in trouble. So remember, it's very critical. For each condition, you need more than one observation, okay? So what happened to this? What happened here? You understand? If only one observation, this is the next one. Yeah. Only one observation, this will be equal to zero. Zero. Okay, so you need more than one observation for each condition, okay? So here, what happened here? If you treat them like a two-way ANOVA, then what is all? This is the main effect. This is the block. And this is the model is here. 4 factorial. And you don't do anything. And the normal table. What's going on? What's going on? Nothing, nothing, nothing. Zero. What? What happened? Because like a two-way ANOVA, no, actually it's not two-way ANOVA. the error time is zero. Understand? You never know. How come this is zero? Because the formula? No formula? Each combination is only one observation, you got zero, 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 zero. You cannot get zero for, because the formula, based on the formula, you cannot be zero. The denominator cannot be zero. That's under prime school. That's, it's impossible for denominator zero. Okay. So two Brock. Like two aroma, each one is only one observation, then you got, that's why you got zero. This is Brock. This is Brock. This is the put different system. So it looks like each one of them are only one observation, so this one you got zero. Do you pay attention?
Yeah.
Two-way ANOVA. This is two-way ANOVA. Each one of them, you shoot more than one. Otherwise, the sum square of an error term will be equal to zero. Okay? This is two-way ANOVA. And the block is not two-way ANOVA. It's not too well anymore. It's broad. So how are you going to do? You got zero? You got zero, there is no way you can get the F value and P value. Because the error term is zero. The particular frame is zero. So how are you going to do? Here. You need to specify by yourself the main effect and these two. Okay, no interaction. No interaction. Because this is not two-way ANOVA.